friends, and welcome to the pre-market update. First, the global indices. Wall Street ended flat on Thursday as a steep fall in energy sector has countered some of the solid earnings reported in the US. The stock index, with major stock indexes closing little change after the US House of Representatives have cleared the healthcare overhaul bill. If we see Dow, S&P and Nasdaq were flattish, whereas S&P and Nasdaq were positive by around 2.5 points, whereas Dow was down around 6 points. Coming over to the European markets were trading mildly positive or closed mildly positive. FTSE was up around 14 points, that is plus 0.2%. The key data to watch out in US today is the non-farm payrolls data. And France's presidential elections results would be there on Sunday. So that would be the key data to watch out over the weekend. Coming over to the Asian markets are struggling as traders await the US non-farms payrolls data, which is later in the day, and after drops in commodity prices overnight has pulled down the indices. If we see, Nikkei was the only market which was trading in green, whereas Hang Seng and Shanghai were trading down around 0.5 to 0.9%. Coming over to the Indian markets, yesterday we have seen benchmark indices settle at all-time highs as banking stocks climbed after the government's initiative to tackle the bad loans or the surging bad loans. And ICICI numbers were taken very positively by the markets, and the stock was up 9%, which pulled the Bank Nifty as well as the Nifty also in the green zone or towards the all-time highs. It is said that government is now one step closer to the new NPA policy as well as the new steel policy. This has propelled the markets from the consolidation zone and moved towards 9400. SGX Nifty, following tracking the global queues, is trading negative around down 37 points and would be likely opening at around 9350 levels. Coming out to the ADRs, major ADRs were trading positive, from Infosys, Wipro, HDFC Bank and ICICI Bank trading positive in the range of 0.2 to 0.8%, whereas Dr. Reddy's ADR was negative by 2.25%. So that is the only negative on the ADR's front. If we see FIS activity, FIS was sellers in Indian markets yesterday to the tune of 601 crores, whereas domestic institutions were buyers in the Indian markets to the tune of 926 odd crores. Now let's look at some of the trading ideas for the day. Tata Communications is the first trading idea, it is short. Tata Communications reported Q4 loss of 260.8 crores. Versus a profit of 1413 crores, that is quarter on quarter. Loss from continuing operations came in at 982.4 crores versus a profit of 1.3 crores. So now numbers were bad. So short Tata Communication, current market price is 706. The stop loss should be kept at 720 for a target of 685 and 670. Next trading idea is MCX. MCX also reported poor set of numbers yesterday. Volumes were down 16.5%, whereas gold volumes were down 51% and silver volumes were down by 26%. So this was a major negative. EBITDA is also down 28%, whereas EBITDA was 21% versus 30.2%. So all in all, poor set of numbers from MCX, and idea is short MCX. Current market price, it is trading at 1155. Stop loss should be kept at 1172 for a target of 1120 and 1100. The next idea is Oberoi Realty. It has reported good set of numbers yesterday, so it is long. Oberoi Realty revenues were up 26% at 290 crores, whereas EBITDA was up 52.3% at 152 crores, and PAT was up 50% at 102 crores. So all in all, good set of numbers from Oberoi Realty. Action to be taken is long. Current market price is 396 for a stop loss being kept at 388 for targets of 407 and 405 in Oberoi Realty. Now let's look at some of the news updates for the day. Godrej Properties planning new launches in quite a few cities, that is Mumbai, Pune, Bangalore and NCR region. SH Kelkar board is considering buyback and they would meet on May 12 to consider the buyback. Reliance to buy coal-bed gas from its own block at $4.23 per MMBTU. Government has signed MOA to purchase 1000 megawatt wind power. Equity ETF's asset base has jumped three folds to 43,234 crores. Pulses import to fall by 20% after we have seen better output in FY18. Adani has signed a steel supply agreement deal with Australian group Arium. CBI has arrested REI Agro's promoter, that is Sanjay Jhunjhunwala, in a loan fraud case. There are quite a few changes in indexes which will be effective from May 26. We have highlighted in a Nifty change, that is Grasim is going out and Vedanta is coming in to Nifty. The effective change is from May 26. Others, we have Nifty 100, Nifty 500 and Nifty Midcap index is also having some changes, so one can go through the circular for the same. Patanjali is eyeing 20,000 crores turnover in FY18 or in this year. Currently it is doing around 10,000 odd crores, so it is seeing a one-fold jump or it is planning to double its revenues or turnover. Adani may face hefty fine in the Australia's green breaches, that is the environmental problems. So it may face a hefty fine. Ordinance to tackle bad loans worth 6 lakh has been cleared and it has gone for a presidential nod. JP Associate defaults on interest payments on NCDs. Oil marketing companies are on radar as we see crude at 5-month low and INR at 20-month high, so we could see some pressure on OMCs. On the results front, IFL Holding reported PAT of 186.4 crores versus 136.5 crores YOY. Imami PAT came in at 83.2 crores versus 82.1 crores. Some poor set of numbers from Imami. If we see L&T Infotech reported good set of numbers, Q4 PAT came in at 244.7 crores versus 235.9 crores quarter on quarter. MRF reported a negative PAT of 32.2% at 287 crores, that is down 32%. Versus 423 crores YOY, so poor set of numbers from MRF. The stock was already under pressure yesterday. HDFC PAT came in at 2040 crores versus 2607 crores, that is down 21% YOY. Advisory picks are Ashok Leyland with upside potential of 25.7%, Sun Pharma with upside potential of 22.6%. IndusInd Bank with upside potential of 18%, NBCC with upside potential of 13.8% and Loris Labs with upside potential of 12.6%. On the results to be announced today, we have quite a few numbers. Apollo Tyres PAT estimates are close to 280 crores. Eicher Motors PAT estimates are 450.8 crores. FSL PAT estimates are 68.4 crores. NIT Tech PAT estimates 73.2 crores. G Shipping PAT estimates 209.7 crores, Blue Dart 38.8 crores PAT estimates, Equitas 34 crores, and we have Shopper Stop announcing numbers, PAT estimates are 6.4 crores. Other than this, we have Atul and Spark also announcing their numbers today, so the stocks could be in action today. That's it friends, I'd like to call upon my derivative expert to give some insights for the day.
Good morning friends, we'll give analysis on derivatives. Yesterday's trading session was a trade where bulls were back in action after seeing Nifty consolidating at 9300 odd levels. We did show some kind of a positive momentum there on 9300 put option, which we were highlighting that it has been showing an highest in terms of open interest and it's been slowly and steadily picking up in terms of open interest, and it's now the highest in terms of open interest and is now the strong support zone for this series, and due to which market did manage to close on a gain of around 0.40%, settled at 9376.95. It was the banking day in yesterday's trading session, being it private sector or PSU banks. Most of all the banks was been able to participate in this up move. Banking sectors were the major outperformer in yesterday's trading session. On the open interest terms, not much of activity. A very minor addition of around 1.5% was added in the open interest. And the absolute terms, 2.62 lakh shares were added in the open interest, while cost of carry decreased significantly from 5% to 3%. That is, Nifty premium rate came down from 28-29 odd points to currently just 17 points. However, we consider majority of the addition which was seen in yesterday's trade was on the longer side. Put call ratio did increase by 5 basis points from 1.13 to 1.18, and volatility index cooled off in line with the market going up. We do see a decrease in volatility index, and that did happen in yesterday's trade. It cooled off from 11.5 to 11.18 odd levels. On the options activity, 9,400 call option have seen minor addition of around 5% odd. Rest all call option have seen a reduction in the open interest, 9,300 and 9,500. 9,500 being the highest in terms of open interest have seen a reduction of 1.5% odd, and 9,300 call option have also seen a reduction of 6.5% odd in yesterday's trade. While on the put side, we have seen significant amount of addition in 9,300 put option, which is now the highest in terms of open interest with around 57 lakh shares into it. And in yesterday's trade, we saw an addition of around 24% odd. So, all in all, 9,300 will now act as a good support for the market, and activity of now 9,400 would be quite crucial to watch out for. A further unwinding in 9,400 call option could now trigger a further upside in the market. But if you see a continuous addition in this strike price, and expect market to be in a range bound between 9,300 to 9,400 levels. On the market level, of 5 days, we have trends at 9,350 with a lower range at 9,350 and higher range at 9,400. On the derivative watch list, based on the derivative parameters, we have identified certain stocks with positive and negative bias. The stock with positive bias are Adani Ports, current market price 340, Hexaware, current market price 238, and Cummins India, current market price 1065. While stock with negative bias are IndusInd Bank, current market price 1429, Tata Motors, current market price 439, and Bharat Forge, current market price 1123. There are four securities in the bank period for today's trade, that is Adani Enterprise, Bharat Finance, JSW Energy and Ujjivan. On the FIS terms, it was surprising to see FIS were being on the selling side in index futures despite market showing a decent amount of up move, especially on the bank Nifty front, but FIS was still on the selling side in index futures. The net sellers by 439 odd crores, while index options net buyers by 1328 odd crores. Stock futures net buyers by 477 crores and stock options net buyers by 40 crores only. That's it from our side. That's it from derivatives. Have a nice trading session.